Alright, let us forge ahead. Let us blur ahead. And then they stop singing. There's no pews in here. Margie! I'm back, everyone! Oh, Margie. We're so glad you're safe. Yes, it's all thanks to Bart and his men. Aren't they hot? Even that old guy is pretty okay. We just received word. So we were singing a hymn of praise and joy. We're so happy. Oh, what a relief. Sister Agnes. Of course there's an Agnes. Welcome back, Margie. We had faith that you and your cousin Bart would one day return safely. And we and your other friends have been waiting for you.
Sister Agnes.
Unfortunately, your mother and the Blessed Royal Mother.
I know, Sister Agnes. They fucking bit it. I heard about it at the Royal Capital. But at least I made it back. I'll never go anywhere or leave you from now on. I live here. It's the only safe place for me. I won't make you all worry anymore, ever again.
Bless you, my dear.
Sister Agnes, this just isn't like you at all. Here I am back safe and sound. Can't you rebuke me just a little, for old time's sake?
What? Oh, I'm sorry. But I'm just so happy that I cannot help but... Sister, there's no reason to be so solemnly quiet. Well, everyone, to celebrate the return of our dear sister Margie, and to express our joy to heaven, let us finish singing our hymn.
Oh, thank you and bless you all. Oh, yes, sister. May I go upstairs? It's been oh so long, so I want to have a look around up there, too.
Oh, but of course, dear. Don't even think of holding back from anything. Except for one thing. Never stay away so long like that again.
I knew you'd say that. Now that's the Agnes I know. Margie, I'm so glad.
Okay, thanks everybody.
Been a while since the last time I was here.
Something wrong, Margie?
No, nothing. It's just... I guess I got a little emotional.
Anyhow, take it easy for a while. You've put up with enough, okay?
If you're trying to make me cry, you'll fail. Oh, right. I'll show fan sight around our cathedral. Follow me!
Nyoom! Off she goes. What a strong girl she is. It's obvious that she really wants us to break down and to just break down and cry.
Yeah, you're right. That's just the way she's always been. For all her talk, she understands her position well. Maybe there are a few things I could learn from her too.
Oh, Bart. Trying desperately to be a good leader. Look at these flat textures.
Aw, they tried.
I mean, that's all they are in other things. That looks like a spooky face. Like a beholder. Can I talk to you?
You must have been through so much at the Royal Capital.
Can I only talk to your- nope. Nope, they won't talk to me.
They're singing! Don't interrupt, they're singing.
Okay. We go up to the gallery on the second floor from here.
Okay. Guess we gotta walk. Ass to balls.
Isn't it so beautiful? What's these big... Oh, they're probably cables holding up the floor. Or they're just fucking... Oh, no. Oh, they're... Okay.
How magnificent!
If we ever got scolded for pranks as kids, Bart and I used to hide up here.
Hey, stop telling them old stories. It's embarrassing.
But to me, Bart hasn't changed much since then.
What? You mean that you think I'm still a kid?
No. Bitch, what?
Ha!
Oh, I can't get over. I can't jump over her, boo! They're singing. I like the view from here the best, because I can just watch everybody sing.
Oh, no, it's this... thing. Two angels.
They each only have one wing. One looks like a lady and one looks like a dude.
There are statues. Yes, this is breathtaking. Light from outside shining through the stained glass of the cathedral's front. What a brilliant piece of artistry this is.
Did you notice that the two great angels only have one wing each?
I did! Let's look at it again.
According to a legend handed down in Nissan, God could have created humans perfectly, but he chose not to. But then humans would not have helped each other. So that is what these great single-winged angels symbolizes. In order to fly, they are dependent on one another.
I mean, I guess it's just symbolism, but I don't know it. Oh, so that is the reason for it. I see. On further inspection, the left angel looks somewhat masculine, while the right one looks somewhat feminine. Well, that is an unusual feature, is it not? Usually these depictions are not gender-specific. But these angels are clearly distinguishable as having opposing genders. And the space between them is the path from where God advents.
Satan?
Or could it be the path leading to God? Marguerite has looked at him because he's just fucking rambling and pacing around. Well, I do not know. It could be either or even both. Now I see!
Bart's not looking at him.
This all coincides with the teachings of Nissan.
Faye's looking at her right, what? The fuck? Wait, Dr. Satan is okay. You're such an amusing fellow.
Oh, excuse me. It's a habit of mine. Why they call me doctor. The doc knows a lot of things. Sometimes I can't even understand what he's talking about.
Ha! Forcing them to fly together? It would be less bothersome if they could fly on their own, don't you think, Faye? Bart, you miss the deeper meaning and beauty of it.
Yeah, I guess.
Someday I wish I could be of help to someone like that. Oh, we haven't visited the room of Sophia yet, have we? You're really supposed to go through some procedures before you can see it, but this time I think it'll be alright if I make a special exception.
Sophia?
Yes, Sophia. She's revered as the founding mother of the Nissan Nation, and the founder of the Nissan religion who set forth its teachings. There's a special room upstairs that has a portrait of Mother Sophia in it.
I would definitely like to view that. Faye, let us have a look at it. So, that was... This, compass?
Is angled to the...
Haha! Margie's mad.
The sisters are still singing downstairs, so they won't be back for a while.
There's a ladder! Where does it go? Nowhere!
Okay. Is there anything in here? Is there anything of use in here? There's no boxes. There's no interactable.
Where does this ladder go?
Nowhere.
Okay. Well,
Guess I got excited for nothing. Margie? Let's go to the painting room. The sisters will probably be back by then. Give her.
I just wanted to investigate.
Sorry, Margie.
The compass, because is level with the ground. So because the camera is currently really level with the ground, the compass is just fucking flat. And that makes me laugh. Time to RP walk up these stairs again. We so wiggly? Because of the way of the movement? I don't know. Sorry.
I think it's funny! This is a really long staircase. It's farther on in. Why do you not have quotations around your speech?
Here it is! Does that look familiar? For those unfamiliar because it's been so goddamn long, this is the opening cutscene, Doohickam. He's standing in the middle of it! Oh my, what an exquisite portrait. And the beautiful young lady portrayed is quite beyond comparison, too. What is more, this looks rather familiar. What do you think, Faye? Yes, I was just thinking the same thing. The hair is different color, but the atmosphere and personality about her are exactly the same. What? Hair color? What do you mean? What do I mean? Look. It's the girl I met in the forest. It's Ellie. I mean, there's something about her that's just like Ellie. You don't think so? I mean... Yes, now that you mention it, she does resemble Ellie. But that's not what I was talking about. I meant that the brush techniques and overall style used in this picture are similar to yours. Really? Let's look at it! She's got the thing on her boobs.
Does it?
First of all, I'm nowhere near as good an artist. No, it's very similar to your style. But somehow I can sense an atmosphere of sadness in this picture. She is smiling, but in a way that gives the impression that she is anxious. It's also unfinished. In the bottom right-hand corner of the canvas, it's not done. And bottom, like, fourth of it? Fifth of it? The bottom part is a little... just sort of paint, like, frantically. Perhaps the picture is reflecting her inner self? Or perhaps it is the inner feelings of the artist being conveyed? That was a weird cadence I did there. Ah. If you look closely, you'll notice that the painting is not completely finished. Yep. The artist put his brushes down when it was near completion. Or it's like, oh my god! Why is that? Or she's like, look, I just fucking live here. I don't fucking know. My grandmother might have known about it, but she's dead? Thanks for reminding me. Oh, what if we ask Agnes? She might know something. Let's rock and roll. Let's go ask the Agnes. This is a weird room, you know? Just one big-ass room with no chairs. And this thing. This streams of light. Anyway. Sorry. Alright then, I'll be with Sister Agnes. Well, shall we head back to the town for now? Yes, alright. But this painting has caught my curiosity. Do you mind if I speak to Sister Agnes before we head back to town? Yeah, right. We'll stop by her room on the way out. Look at it again, Faye! Is something wrong, Faye? You look like you were daydreaming. Huh? No, it's nothing. It was a memory of him painting her while she sat in that room. And then the word Lacan showed up. Fucking go in the door. Oh shit. It's been 15 minutes. Noom. I just jumped down. Damn. There's people in here. I mean, there's like normal people, not nuns. What do you say, sir? As a matter of fact, the guy next to me and I were born here. Years ago, we both got tired of the peaceful but boring life here, so we ran away from home. Both ended up enlisting in the army. It's not that we have any particular happy memories or whatever here. It's just that, after all, this is the land of our birth, so, you know. Preparations should be started near the border of the sixth country for the charge by the Royal Capital's army. But a miscalculated move directed on the enemy is starting to backfire on us, so we'll be taking covert action for a while. I'm on my way there now, but I thought I'd offer a prayer before I go. By the way, here's our whole plan. Don't tell anybody.
I want to see with my own eyes what will become of this country.
Alright. Oh, there's doors down here! Did I go in this door? I went in this door. Sorry. I got excited. Because they said go talk to the sisters, and I don't know where that is. Is it on this side? No, they're probably in that other, the only other room in this building. The library. Yeah. Sorry, everybody. But I can run now. I don't have Margie slowing my ass down.
Because she wants to look at stuff. She wants to show us a tour of the cathedral that only has 3-4 fucking rooms. And 2 of those rooms are stairs.
All of them have the same sprite, so who the oh, this must be Agnes. Agnes!
I wonder what kind of person Sophia was. I would have loved to meet her. Fuck. Sorry. I'm a little tired from my captivity.
I understand you were shown Sophia's portrait. The lady portrayed in that picture is Nissan's great founding mother. Some say it was painted at least 500 years ago. 500 years ago. Now that is quite amazing. Personally, I find it intriguing. Do you have any historical material from that period? In our hands, there are no such records left intact. All records and materials concerning Sophia have been lost. The portrait is the only thing left. We too do not know much, have much knowledge about her.
That is too bad. So there really is nothing left at all.
For someone who has helped Marguerite, I would have loved to have shared them. But unfortunately, I'm unable to help here.
Oh well, none the matter.
Please do not worry about it. I was just inquiring. But it does seem somewhat strange. If such a majestic building as this survived history, then it is likely a scroll or two would remain. According to tradition, Sophia was present about 500 years ago. She sacrificed herself for the people and has been summoned to be with God. That's all I can tell you.
Okay. So everything was lost in the darkness of history?
Okay. The one pictured in the portrait in the painting is Sophia. She's the first great mother of Nissan. According to legend, the portrait was painted 500 years ago.
Thanks, everybody. I wonder what kind of person Sophia was. I would have loved to have met her. Okay.
Somewhere. It must be somewhere. The truth that we have not yet come to know.
Oh!
That scared me.
You're very devoted.
Well, sort of. It's just that after sneaking into the capital, I started to think about a lot of things. I've come to realize the world isn't right the way it is now. Yeah. Is it ever? Should I talk to these ladies?
Why does war never disappear from this world? To me, it's clear that it's meaningless. Perhaps it's our fate to be forever at discord with each other.
That's why we only have one wing, and we just want to have two. Later, bitch. Fucking camera angle nonsense. Whatever. Okay, well, what a waste of time. Time to get out of here, I think. They look very squishy, these sprites. I wanna squish them. He has a couple frames of animation for his feet coming closer for perception? For whatever. Big ass doors! Let's go back to town. It does the heart good to see innocent play of children. Did I go in here? I did not! There's a painting in here. There's paintings in here. Hey, fat guy.
No, something's not right.
Shit! Okay. He's got a bunch of pixelated paintings, probably because of my set of graphic settings. What about you, dude? Or lady? I forgot. Your ketchup? It's a blank canvas! They can't figure out what to paint! That's sad. Oh, I almost thought that was a butt for a minute. God. Ah! It's Bison! Young master! Hey, Bison. Hey, everybody. The people of Nissan were most generous to allow us to rent this house, so there'll be no need to seek lodgings at the inn for a while. Also, Master Saigood wishes a word with you regarding your next move, if he may. Alright, so where is Sig? The good Master Saigood is waiting for you inside. Oh, well thanks, Mason. Just gonna stand here? Master Saigood awaits you inside, so... I forgot to do old man mouth. I'm just doing old man voice.
Whenever I come in here, it always calms my heart. My cold, dead heart. Anyway, young master, I want to work out what your plans are from here on out.
Alright. But before we do that, there's something I want to ask you.
Me?
Yeah, you. There's four beds in here! I was right! Oh, he had to take him away to the next room. He's wearing a crop top. Sig? What's up with you and that Gebler officer? What's the connection between you and him? You know, you sure know a lot about Gebler for some reason. We've brought in ambient noises. And also Saiten. Okay. Saiten has nodded.
Alright, I'll tell you. Me and Saiten here, we used to live in Solaris.
Solaris? You mean where Gebler's from?
That's right.
Why did we look at Mison for a minute?
Solaris calls foreigners lambs. They're used as manual labor. Basically, it's slavery.
Slavery? Focus on Faye. Is that where you met him?
Yes, it was there. We worked for the Solaris government for a short while.
Well, we learned to dislike their methods and escape the first chance we had. Look at Faye. Take a few steps. You were friends with these people? I met you when I was a kid, and we've been together ever since then. So this would have had to have happened even before then. I probably wouldn't have understood this if I had heard it earlier, but... why didn't you think I could deal with it now? Surely you could have told me about this. Especially when you had something to do with the people who were backing that Shikan idiot. Shit! I wish you told me sooner. There's nothing I can do about that now. But there's one thing I want you to believe. We left Solaris on our own will and for our own reasons. Now they've appeared before us, we can't just sit back and do nothing. If need be, I will give my life to stop them. Doesn't usually do much if you just die. Bart is having doubts. Alright, I understand. Can you elaborate a little more? He sat down! Where is Solaris? What bugs me is this surface dwellers thing. It's as if Solaris is in another location, like up in the clouds or something. Yes, well. Tis. Etranank, the capital, it's mistypo, of the Solaris Empire is located in the skies above. Solaris is separated from the land by dimensional distortion fields known as gates. Okay. Passing between the two requires special means of transportation, such as an airship. Okay. To get to Ave, we stowed away in our regular flight to the surface. I came much later than Saiga did, but I also escaped in the same way. Okay. I'm not sure why we had that outside shot. Some of these shots are weird, and I... they have to be deliberate because they have to program them in, but, like... they're not... their reasoning for doing so isn't obvious. What are lambs? That is the word Solarians use to indicate those who live on the Earth. As I said before, such surface dwellers or Earth dwellers are used for manual labor there. Manual labor could be anything from soldiers to administrative jobs. Solaris gathers its workforce from the land dwellers. Jobs are divided up by who is most suitable. Sometimes people are brainwashed. Brainwashed?! When you, young master, were still an infant, I was used as a test subject. There was probably something they valued inside of me. You too, Doc? No. I was born in the lower city levels. It's not a complete secret, but I guess I'm a Solarian. You see, you still need people to run a country. No matter how scientifically advanced you have no support without people. Pure Solarians are rare. They would not even make up a quarter of Ave's total population. So they support their country by stealing surface dwellers. Okay. Next question. Who is that man? His name is Kar. Karin Ramses. As you know, he's the Gebler commander. Ramses? I kicked his ass. I rammed his sus. We call him Kar. In Solaris, there's an officer training school called Jugend. I want to say it's Jugend. It's probably Jugend. He became the commander after leaving there. He's a lower level citizen, same as me. However, with his amazing abilities, after graduating, he rose through the ranks with unparalleled speed. That man had one ideal: to achieve a consolidation of all his colleagues. Even land dwellers, if they had talent, were brought into the army. So you two were picked by Ramses? No, we were not picked by him. We aligned ourselves with him. God, keep up, you dumb... At that time, we agreed with him. At that time, Ramses was our hope. He had high ideals and wanted to change the system in Solaris. His name used to be Megillus. To us test subjects and lower-level citizens, he was truly all that we wished for.
A benefactor?
Yes, finally I could begin to understand. Even I, a test subject, was changed by his ideals.
Okay. Last question. Why did you leave? They already said a lot of these things. I don't know why we're going over again. So why was it that you wanted to flee from Solaris? Uh-oh. Another fucking camera.
We were placed in key military positions by Ramses. And thanks to that, we came to know the relationship between Solaris and the surface dwellers.
The lambs, right?
You know, I pledged myself to you. I didn't realize you would be this stupid. They weren't just using us lambs for slave labor. They also selected some of us, like me, to be used as subjects and experiments to refine the drugs. Drugs that change people's personalities to make them more aggressive and to draw out their latent abilities. They were using us as human guinea pigs to test the psychological alteration drugs.
You know, I'm not gonna go into it. Human guinea pigs, huh? Experimenting on humans? Gross.
Yes, for example. Drive.
We learned about that in an earlier scene.
That drug and all others like it are used now.
Sorry.
That drug and all others like it that are used now are byproducts of human experimentation. However, the role of such experimental subjects was not limited to just that. Excuse me.
This drive drug is something that anyone in the Solaris Army can use? At least anyone in the Gebler forces who was sent to the surface. You're worried about her, huh? Shut up! I saw some in her room. I saw some drugs in her room.
Oh, no!
Anyway, using slaves as guinea pigs? How low are these fuckers?
Damn!
I understand. I think I get most of it.
I fucking hope so.
Hey, old man. Go reserve the town hall for us. We'll finish talking there. I'm going outside to get some air. Okay, bye. Tiger?
I should have been honest with him sooner.
It is best not to worry about it. You did all you could at the time. The young one will understand. My son, you okay, buddy? I'm sure the young master would never have dreamed of such a tale. I guess you already knew? Well, now that you ask, yes, I did. However, when Saigon was telling a story, I thought it was best to stay quiet. Please try and help the young master come to terms with all he's heard. Is there a save point in here? Shit! Time to go find Bart on the bridge, probably, because it's the best place for us out. Yep. Cinematically, this is the best place to have a conversation. I had no idea Sig had such a past.
Are you still suspicious of Saigon?
Well, I mean, it was just so sudden. I kind of expected to hear something different, like that we were childhood rivals or something. But that's nothing compared to the story he just told us, is it?
So hearing a story has you confused because it was not so simple. There was a time when he was cooperating with one of Gebler's generals. Furthermore, behind Gebler was a country that you had never even heard of.
Hey, what are you picking on me for?
No, I'm not picking on you or blaming you or anything on you. What I'm saying is this. If you think about how he feels, then you should see why he could not talk about this with you till now. Looking at the activities of Solaris toward the other countries up until now, it has never gone beyond simply maintaining their own empire or self-preservation. As you have seen it, the military power is immense, so Sigurd is probably thinking ahead. First, he was probably concentrating on taking care of the problems here on the country of Ignis. Once things were settled here, it would give him a stronger foundation to deal with Solaris later, which is a much better plan than rushing straight into a war he knew he could not win. Quite logical, really. Sounds like you understand one another pretty well. Well, it's not like we're newly acquainted, is it? We had talked about a lot of things up until we decided to escape from Solaris. Speaking of that, why did you leave? That Ramses guy was supposed to be a star of hope or something, wasn't he? Faye's here too! Yes, I certainly thought so at first, but then I realized his way of thinking really was not that much of a change from the previous system. Basically, the only difference was whether they stressed people's rank and class or their skill. The words had changed, but it was still no different from what Solaris itself had been doing until then. He had no intentions of bringing everyone a better way of life. In other words, he's an elitist. I don't think I like him much either. So, Sighton, you think I can beat Gebler? Oh no, you're fucked. Why, are you planning on fighting them? As long as they're working with Shakan, there's no way around it. The way things are going, I'm sure we'll have to fight them sooner or later. I suppose so, but even if we were to defeat the Gebler forces here, there's still Solaris to deal with. If we're not careful, it is possible that we may get involved in a longer war than with Shakan. Do you not agree that continuing the way we have been going is rather hard on everyone? I think it's time we try to get help from a greater number of people. So, defeating Shakan's not going to get rid of the likes of Gebler. I know what you're trying to say. To vanquish Gebler, first gain thy throne, right? I mean, you could put it that way. What do you mean you could put it that way? But then again, maybe it is time I did something about that. Oh, okay. That kid's going fucking nuts down there. It's fucking nuts. Hey. I'll get you. Alright. Out of the way. Out of the way! Is this the town hall? Nope. This is our house. No one's here. I guess we have to go to the town hall, but I don't remember where it is. Is it this one? I guess this one. I went to the tool shop to borrow a table. The owner said, if we need anything for the young master, just ask for it.
I'm grateful. Not sure why we rented out the town hall for nothing, for just the five of us. When I was a kid, I borrowed stuff from there and got in big trouble.
Borrowed.
What did you take? A toy boat. At least I think that's what it was. I put fireworks in it and let it float on the cathedral's lake. I always used to play Navy. I'm not sure, but I think I pretended the lake was the open sea, and I was the fleet commander. Anyway, forget those old stories. Sorry about that. Got distracted. We need to get started. Music change! We're serious now! First, Gebler's the big problem. Yes, Ramses is headed towards achieving his goals. That he is now the commander of Gebler is proof of that. A normal man could not progress so quickly through that country's organization. And now he's presently located here in Ignis.
Frankly, the situation is not very favorable. We need to somehow find a weak spot and attack it with all our might. First, let's just concentrate on Chacon. Once he's out of the way, and Ave is safe again, we can think about how to deal with Gebler. First Gebler! Scratch that. First Chacon. With our present strength, we should be able to hold off the Royal Guard forces. The problem is how to deal with Gebler in the meantime. They will most likely move at Chacon's request. They're not just going to sit by and watch quietly. May I have a look there, please? Okay, buddy. Excuse me. In short, we want Gebler to leave for a while. At least until we're able to take back the royal capital, Bledovic. Okay, so what's the plan? Okay. Are those the cities? Are those floaty bits the cities? These are the Gebler units currently in Ave, correct? That's Nissan! Up there in the top. The Western Gods. The Royal Capital Defense Force. And this Lego piece. Units along the front line at the border with Kislev. Got a big desert here with some yellow things. There are three main groups. Each is made up of a mix of Gebler and Ave forces. Only two of these are very large. Are those the cities? Are those the floating bit, the spinny ones? The Royal Capital's defense units and the Kislev boarding units. The Western Guard along Nissan's border are a little more of a surveillance team. Okay. In order to recapture the Royal Capital, it will be necessary to draw these defenseless units away from Bledovic. We have some Kislev-made gears, correct? Yeah, we captured some earlier. Yeah. What if we use those gears to make a raid on the Western Guards? Here at the border with Nissan. Blue! I see. We'll draw them out by making it look like Kislev is invading Ave. On the west coast. But the problem is, will attacking the border guards be enough to set the center in motion? Bitch, I don't know. To be sure, then, Nissan will have to appear to align with Kislev. If they see it that way, they will certainly make a move. You're saying that you intend to use Nissan as bait? Dark! Chacon is very sensitive to Nissan's and Kislev action. If Nissan starts moving, he will probably leave it up to Gebler, but... Of course, I do not wish to do that from the beginning. But looking at the situation, we have to be willing to go that far. First, we infiltrate into the capital. To take out Chacon, we'll have to meet up with our agents already in the city. We're forgetting one thing, the frontline units along Kislev's border. What?
You just talked about them.
They're coming in hot.
The main strength of Ave's fleet is the battleship Kefenzel. Kefenzel? It's been in service since the reign of the last king. Because of its firepower, the whole unit is nicknamed the Invincible Fleet. I recall yesterday's intelligence report said that the ship is near the border.
Is this riveting?
Damn, that puts everything in jeopardy. Do not feel so down. I simply wanted to see the current distribution of force in the area. Even in the worst case that they do come, it will not be such a great problem.
What do you mean?
I have some additional information about Ave's border fleet. The former Ave Supreme Commander was transferred there. Not really transferred, more like demoted. His name is Vandercom.
Vandercom?
You don't mean the Vandercom that was in Jugend?
The very same.
Young one, he has not been able to adapt to the change in tactics, Particularly following the introduction of Gears, he is a man who will never stray from his dependence on large naval guns. You mean he's stubborn. He's all size and no real military power. An excellent target for pirates.
Young master, this is not going to be an act of piracy.
I'm just kidding. I don't know, that sounds like a good idea. Actually, the number of gears assigned to the fleet seems to have been reduced. Even with that, how gallant of him to be so self-righteous. Is he that much of a musclehead? It'll be fun taunting him.
Young master!
I know. Anyway, Sighton, do you think he can strike our gear forces? It is not a problem. Even with Vandekam, we have enough forces left to pull off the feint. However, it would not be wise to underestimate our opponents. Let's look at the goofy map. Well, now that we know what we're up against, here's what we'll do. Bait these assholes. Apart from our main unit heading for Lenovik, we must keep the fleet at Kislev border from returning to the capital. How? We have like 5 dudes. So you're suggesting we have another unit? A few effective soldiers to hold the enemy at bay. A small force is best. It'll be fine. A small force. What if Faye leads a group of gears there? Faye's like, what? Me? Huh? I was thinking about Sophie. Hi, Faye. Remember you? Me? Hold on now. There's no reason to involve you in all this. Okay, I'll do it. Yes, let me do it. When do we leave? Character arc stuff. Are you sure? We've come this far. Hey, we're friends to the end now. Social link, go. Faye will now die for you. Speed is everything. We should do this as soon as possible. Alright, tomorrow. I am truly grateful, Faye, Sighton. Yeah. Yeah! Get hype! There's no way we can lose.
Well put, young master.
Cool! We have something resembling a plan. Except...
Good morning! What's up, fuckers? What's with that long face? Not feeling well? Or are you feeling sad about saying goodbye? Or maybe you're just nervous?
Shut the fuck up. Don't bug me.
What? Seriously though, what the fuck is with the faces? Well, it's almost time.
Yeah. Everyone ready to go? I'll be waiting here, so let me know when you're through preparing.
Fucking, is there a safe point in this town? Jesus Christ.
I gotta... Okay. Whatever. Talk to Sigurd! There's still some time until we leave. Why don't you make preparations? Meissen? I've been waiting for this day for a long time. I don't know. He's supposed to be old, but he looks really...
Bart told me you're helping out with the plan, too? So you're caught up in this now as well.
I've come this far, I might as well stay till the end.
Thanks. I know you'll do a good job. I mean, Chu thinks you're a hottie.
You ready? No. I'll be waiting, so call me when you're ready to go.
Just fucking...
There's a new wind blowing today.
Alright, you know what? I will,
end the video here, because it's been 50 whole fucking minutes. And we will come back and engage in this plan, I guess. Get fucking hype!